or the plasma cutter. The cord's right there. I've got airline stuff out already. But yeah, you're either way. Yeah, no, that's why I said if you want to take the plas, then you need those goggles for the plas. Plas is right there. I'll get you an airline. Put this bad boy on its stand. Flip my camera around. Hey everybody, so John Whitney from Whitney's Whitetails is how I actually found out about their trailer and that they were in need. I'm getting this set up so you guys can all tune in and watch the action as the day progresses. We have, to the best of my knowledge, we have all the parts here. I'm gonna set my phone up on a tripod and so everybody out there can see us do our magic. I'll give you here in just 1 second a little view of what we got going on. We don't have as cool of a gear for recording as they do. We're pretty primitive. But all right, let's swap the camera around. All right, so here is one of the two axles. They're just a blank axle tube. I have to take, so you find center on it, find center, then you mark your mounting perches and weld your mounting perches on. But last night, if you watched the video, I plasma cut the axles off. There's a little bit extra overhang. John's got this one done. And we are going to, or he is going to take the plas and snap a little bit more off. And then we're going to get measurements and marks so we can start putting the new axles on. But this stream will be going all day. You guys can feel free to tune in periodically if you like. I'm gonna set it up on my tripod. Gonna get it plugged in. When this is all done, we'll have a full video of this as well. Nope. Use that curly hose, John. The blue one right there. And then plug an orange one into it. See the orange cord? Oh, shit. Josh, give him the orange cord. I forget he's colorblind. Yeah. Just add in to it. There's two of them laying there. I apologize, the camera will be steady here in just a minute. Oh no. Man of life. Almost got to put this thing in the road so we can see everything. Nope, air's on. Just walk over where they see the refrigerator straight in. Jen's never helped me at this shop yet. No, straight in front of you. This way. Straight to the west. See the circuit box or the breaker box? Center 220 breaker. Flip it up. Then the air's hot. Well, that's about as good as view as I can get, and I just gotta get a cord over here.
This way. There we go. Okay. Now go.
you two go grab the other axle for us. They don't weigh nothing.
Okay. This one's the right way?
Yeah.
Okay.
Good job, you guys.
I don't like that, John.
Huh? Said I don't like that.
What?
Rain.
Huh?
Rain.
Oh, that sucks.
Yeah. It'll be a miserable day in the rain.
Sit down there, Brooke. Good job. Josh, come put your foot on this thing or hold that box so I can. Give me 1 second. Yep, that's good.
Perfect.
Hey, we're almost all set up. This way, having everything on a cord, I don't have to worry about it at all today. I'm trying to get you guys a better view. Give me a second. I want to get a view of everything going on. That's probably about as good as I can get it. We'll periodically, when the video comes out, you'll see. We'll get some more close-ups and stuff.
You getting it figured out, John?
Yeah, it's kind of fine.
Okay. Alright, they got lots of new tips and nozzles. That's why I switched to that one. No, it's doing fine. In the front, grab four rays, or grab the thing of rays.
Grab the thing of rays.
Front of the shop. No, front of the shop. Go by the toolbox.
Oh.
Blue ray.
Okay.
On a paper towel hanger in front of the shop. Thank you.
anybody from Redneck Trailer Supply is watching, you guys forgot to send some parts.
These are nuts. Two bolts. Those are my lug nuts and bearings.
Josh, you guys want to go down to my enclosed trailer?
The height.
Way down at the other end of the yard. Go look in it and see if there is anything else. Another bag or...
So where is it?
At the other...
All the way down, follow this road. All the way down, you'll see the trailer.
Yeah. Okay. Check the mailbox too.
Okay.
That you walk by.
Yep,
the okay. First one.
Okay. First one. First one.
Having hardware on hand, you never have everything.
Nope.
Oh, there's 3/8. That I might actually have. It'll be stainless steel, but it's not going to last long.
right at it.
He's a much better. Well, it's not the whole way through there, too. They said they were smoking before they left, and it used to be it. When you left Oregon, it's kind of like an easy thing. And that's the one that's definitely fucking up. But somebody would have bought them material, so I don't know.
Thank you. right on grease. They don't care.
They're pretty awesome.
Alright, so. They would have given me grease about 10. Like grease is there.
They're not.
A YouTube video.
Josh and Charlie.
Okay.
Put your bikes over there out of the way, so out of the camera. Because it's live right now.
Josh, this is how... Is that Josh that have a kickstand? Oh. What is this?
If they were straight when you put a load on them, then they would bend the other way. So when you put a load on this axle, it actually goes into, it'll be straight. So this axle is fully loaded. Besides the shoes you wear. Bet you there's 15 pairs of shoes. Oh yeah. Four? How many pairs of shoes do you want? We got a whole basket full of four.
Hey Dad!
Oh hey, you guys picked over the road for it. You guys gotta watch out.
I haven't even been down here.
I didn't say you were.
Oh. Dad. Do you know where the Swiffer bottle blue thing is? Or do you know if we have any more?
Maybe in the bathroom upstairs.
I looked there. It's not there. And we looked in your room.
It ain't in my room.
Okay.
Check the pantry.
Okay.
There's another good place for it. Charlie, go get Mom's phone.
Okay.
I need it.
Yeah.
Then I need one of you to record with her.
Yeah.
Hey, watch out. That phone's live, Charlie, on YouTube right now.
Oh. Hold the camera.
No. What are you doing? Please watch. Stay away from that camera, please.
Okay.
Thank you.
What I'm trying to do.
Stay away from the camera.
Mine can go faster than me.
Oh.
No!
Oh, my foot's painful right now. I hit it and I'm bleeding. Let me use that. Use the bike. So much better.
I'm bleeding.
Use the bike first.
Drive it to the house. My mom is a nurse.
Yeah.
Oh, gosh. I don't like this. I don't like this mine.
Quit the starling.
She doesn't know how to.
Oh, God. Quit the starling.
Thank you.
usually be on the creek by 7 or 8. So all the way up being 3.5 inches there. So there's a big stream up in the boat.
Doing here is we're trying to solve one of their issues. So one of their issues was when they put the new tires on the axle that they had, alone from the grease problem that they didn't have the grease, but the tops of their tires was hitting the bottom of the trailer. So we've got it all mocked up. These are stationary beam axles that we had ordered from Redneck, and we have to locate. These are made so you can mount them on any lift frame of trailers. So what we're doing here is we got one side mocked up, and the reason why we mocked it up like this is so that we can see if we have enough clearance in between the frames. And we've already measured from here. This is all mocked up. We got it level. The tube is level with the world. And the level there. This mounts onto the frame, and from here to the top of the frame is 7.75. Oh, shoot. So we're measuring to the wrong side. Start over here. So 5. So 5, no, we have almost, we have 2.75. We need 3. That's really, really close now. So it's 7.875. So I'm going to clear my door.
kids are not tearing the carburetor apart on that dirt bike. You guys can try starting it.
Be useful to them.
Hold on, bro. I don't know where.
Okay, go. Go get your drink.
Okay, go.
Whoa, stay here. Make sure that's the right one. I want to put this tire on.
Thank you.
back portion actually is cut back, so the center line of the axle is actually 4 inches back from that. So this mark here is going to be our new, that's going to be the center of our axle. So we'll measure from here back to here.
The mark on
the
video.
Right. The mark.
There'll be one person, John. One person will know
that. Somebody else will be, yep, that was the wrong mark.
And then if anybody's truly paying attention, well, we're live right now too, but they'll realize that as we're doing it, they didn't put that where they said it was going to. Right? Oh, we need to send you to Menards. We'll make supper this evening when they're here, when we're done,
right.
Or whenever. If we're not done, just make it for everybody else, and me and Donald. John works the same way I do. Right. That's why me and him have always worked so damn well together.
Eat when you're done.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Or if you're dying, then go get something to eat. But that ain't very often. So we need a mix of. Nope, we have lignite.
Oh, you did.
We found lignite. They're not going to hold the backing plate because the axle is.
Okay.
So we need 20 locking fine thread. Steel locking fine thread. We need. I'm going to send a bolt with you.
Okay.
I literally just got off the phone. I don't know who called. I don't even remember.
Somebody called me. I hung up and the text message came in and I'm looking at my phone. Otherwise, I probably went to God. It's probably good.
Yeah.
To the YouTube link, I remember looking at them later on.
Yeah.
I clicked on it, opened it up, and I seen them. And I instantly recognized who it was. I didn't even notice read the thing. And then I seen their Wild Bill's parking lot. And that shit parking lot is just all broken to crap. And I'm like, Charlie, let's go!
I know, then I didn't hear nothing. Then I go back in the house after the walk. I'm like, oh, geez, I got help. Go on there, and I'm like, fast-forwarding a little bit. And all of a sudden, I see down. I'm like, no way. I'm like, this, like, within 20 minutes, the full thing hit me. Like, meant to be.
Right.
I simply watch them all the time.
Right. No, I try to watch all their videos.
They're one of the few I... Grindhard Plumbing Company. Yeah, I watch a lot of their stuff, too. More because I'm jealous that
they get to do it for a living, what I would like to do.
Alright.
So, you don't need this type of nut. So, this is a nylon locking nut.
Paint the wheels too. We're probably actually going to do that up to the house because of the weather. So I would say,
my new motor is leaking oil all over the floor. I'm like, what the fuck?
So you said 3824, what does that mean?
That's the thread pitch. That's what the drawer will say where you get them out of. It's going to be in a drawer of an art.
And these are called what?
Flange nuts. That is exactly what the drawer will say. FaceTime me. FaceTime.
That's right.
You'll find somebody. So then you got one can.
Okay, no,
get five cancers to get five. I got it. Weather turns to shit and gets windy, I'll stick welded. I don't care. I'll never forget your old man when I built that first trailer at Carr.
Yeah.
He came out there one day to see what me and Ty were up to.
And he's like, you're stick welding this whole thing? And I was like, I can't afford a wire fee.
Well, we're gonna have to remark this because I gotta grind things up.
Cool. Please check the seats. Please act like we're gonna take up the
park. We're only located in one.
Yeah, I know, but we got cross seats.
So I just wanna make sure that you don't have to put the exit back farther or farther ahead to center on the beam zone product.
Yeah.
Before we. Well, I didn't realize that we got zero clearance of the tires.
or if it's still going.
Oh, yeah, and
our camera, our GoPro is definitely not getting any footage. Oh, well, we got two people watching. Hey, everybody. I'm not quite sure how to see comments on here. Here, if I can. I'm gonna take you guys out of the holder for a minute. Yeah, I'm glad we were able to come to the rescue. So. I shouldn't have touched it. Sorry for all the wiggles. It's gonna wiggle for a minute. I touched it, now it came loose, and I gotta take it all apart. There we go. Perfect. Hey, if you guys are just joining, this is Adventures with Purposes trailer where we got all our measurements made and it'll be live all day while we're fixing their trailer. You guys can check out the work we're doing.
Well, let's set that shackle up and measurement. Actually.
I think I'm gonna move the live stream to a better angle so they can see more. We don't have the greatest equipment in the world for camera-wise, but we have the equipment to fix stuff and build stuff. All right. Whew. Now we need to adjust the tripod again. There we go. Beautiful. A little crooked. We'll fix that. Give me 1 second, people. Look at that. Urgh. Oops. I gotta take you back out. I think I just turned something on that I didn't want. Yeah. I enabled the flash. For whatever reason, I can't get the comments to stay up. They just keep going away. There we go. All right, so right now, John is assembling the shackles. I'll take you guys over there and show you. So what we're doing here is we've got a measurement for the rear of where we're going to mount the new axles at. But we got to set this up so that we can measure. You guys can kind of see some of the damage to the trailer. The tire came off, it ripped this beam out. That's just a supporting beam for the floor. Goes like this one does right here. And we want the flash on. But so we have to get a measurement and make sure that where these are going to mount. You put that in upside down, John. Put that up in exactly upside down, but it'll work for our measurements. Right. No, we can get our measurements that way.
It's kind of clear.
Right. We gotta take, I don't know if I'm going to cut that out and take it off and straighten it, or if I'm going to straighten it right there. I should be able to straighten that out pretty good. It's pretty thin. But, so yeah, we'll what we needed to figure out is if this piece and this one here and then the one behind it, if it would clear where the tires were or were going to be now, because they're not going to be exactly in the same place as they were before because they're bigger, so they're going to be a couple inches different. But that's it, and there's plenty of room. Perfect. So then we are going to next. I've got to grind the spots, and then we got to redo all our marks on these axles. But then I'm going to... So they ship these axles to you without leaf spring perches. And that is the leaf spring perch right there. So that you can take this perch and put it wherever on the axle it needs to be. So if your frame was way in here, your frame rails, you could put your frame rail there. Our frame rail is, I got better marks on this side, is right here. That is where that perch needs to sit. Obviously, I gotta make sure the axle's level and square and level and square that perch to the axle. The axle is probably, I would say that's pretty level. And then you also gotta check and make sure that it's level this way with where that bolt is, because yeah, you can cheat that. But the axle needs to get turned. Part of this job is having eyes that can see level. People may or may not believe that, but that is a very true fact. Because if you can't see level, you probably can't do this job. And the biggest thing is making sure both those perches are as relative to the same as you possibly can get them. And then we're going to full weld the perches on, and then we'll tack everything up. The perches have, there is no changing where they go, but we'll tack all the other pieces up in place and go from there. All right, I'm gonna put you guys back in the stand, and if you wanna hang out and watch, that'd be awesome. Yep. I just sent the feed to Doug too. That way if they wanna save it or whatever. Cause I know they have moderators and stuff that they're spoiled. That is all there is to it.
Thank you. Here's the thing. Oh, they're there. They didn't go far. I didn't figure they would. Well, the house isn't on fire, and I don't hear any yelling and bloody screaming, so they must be doing all right. Thank you.
Get it out of there. Why'd you bring your table down?
I just
had to. No, I didn't. When I said to bring your table down.
Mom,
I was planning to
come down here.
Who told you to come down here?
The table.
I never said anybody to send you down here. All right, you guys got the whole living room and stuff cleaned up? The kitchen and all the dishes too? Dishes are put away. Tables wiped down and the counters too. Why do you have your kickstand down? What are you doing?
doing, Charlie? Cut the high spots off with your grinder a little bit. Was your cutoff wheel?
Yeah.
I'll get you the grinder, Ben. Yeah, go for it. It's already plugged back in. That's my interruption machine right there.
Huh?
Charlie's my interruption machine. So I, like, lack of get anything done, so I constantly have to start back over. It must have been one bracket short somewhere, because they sent me one for a half inch bigger tube, which is, it isn't the end of the world, but they don't, you just got to be more careful with them because they don't sit on there nicely.
Yep.
Anybody message you that's watching a live feed yet?
No.
No. John, what did we say?
All right, so our one person that's still watching, thank you very much. Hopefully you're watching and not, well, it's cool that you are watching. Show you guys, this isn't no amateur hour. I don't know, I know a couple of people who can wire feed weld better than I can, or as good, maybe not better. We're on par with each other, but haven't even thrown a bead of weld probably 3 months. The first welds I've made. Hello.
Okay, so I'm having a problem.
Okay. Flange nuts? Fine thread flange nuts? Grade 5 at minimum. So that'd just be your generic silver ones. Most of them should be grade 5. What's that? Yeah, they're gonna be in the bins, Tara. Not the individual packages. Yep, on top of the bins, they're all the drawers. I guess they should have said drawers. And then you'll, yeah, in the drawers, look at the drawers. You'll see SAE fine thread on one of the drawers. There'll probably be multiple. FaceTime me. Keep looking. There is fine thread. You always have to keep looking until you find fine thread.
I think all the fine thread is in the same area. Rust-Oleum gloss.
just the I don't want anything special. I would just want the professional series can stuff, because that way it's exactly the same paint anywhere in the country. The world. Yeah, that's fine, I guess, if they don't have the silver cans. I normally always buy the silver cans because that's always the same, where their other cans sometimes vary. It's all right. All right, love you. Thank you. Night.
Here, wait. Can you look up their search team? I want to see if they have any videos. Come on.
They got all kinds of them. Adventures with Purpose.
Okay. Right there. Thank you. Oh, they found a baby.
Text to mom.
Uh-huh.
So John can text mom her number, or John's number. I should have just went with her, John.
Yeah.
Probably would have been easier.
Okay,
can I get your number? Huh? I don't know how
you do this, Dad. You don't know how to send text message? The way it's after the plus sign. Give the phone to John.
Can't use the four-wheeler.
No.
Can I use wood?
not saying it's your fault.
I don't care.
Yeah, but why are you doing this? Menards.
What about, like a trailer section at Fleet Farm and shit? Do they have, do they have that big aisle full of trailers?
That's though? Right, they do now. They never used to.
They've got actual tire tubs.
John just had a really good idea.
They might have something there if you can't find what you're looking for.
You can't, redid the inside of some of their store now.
there, because that one's either for a 3.5. I meant for a 3.5 inch too. Has to fight, it's always gonna lose. Eventually it will lose. Just in case it rains. Right.
You need to get a Mac one, it's yours.
Oh, that's right! Somebody else wanted yours worse than you, huh? I was...
I tell you what. We're live yet.
I know you do. All right, everybody. So we're going to turn the live feed off. We got to run to Fleet Farm, if you just heard. And we'll be back in a little bit. We need some nuts that we're missing from all the parts we got from Redneck Trailer Supply out of Hampton, Iowa. They also have another branch in St. Cloud, and this is not a sponsored video or link by them. They just were some pretty awesome people willing to help us get the parts so we can get these guys back on the road again. But it happens. We're missing the fine thread nuts that hold the backing plates to the axles. And we all, one more, we're gonna try and see if we can find one of the tubing adapters to be able to put it's for a 3.5-inch tube, where these are 3-inch tubes. So we're just gonna go try and find the right one. Otherwise we'll make this one work, but that is where we're at. We'll see you guys in a bit.
See what's gonna be nice.